Are you tired of guessing your color grading and 3D VFX when editing VR180 or using video for MetaQuest or Apple Vision Pro? Because let's be honest, the whole point of editing or grading immersive content is to see what you're actually doing in real time. But even with the latest DaVinci Resolve 20s, it is still surprisingly hard to do. No headset preview, no true color reference, just hope for the best. Today, we are going to fix that. I will walk you through a complete workflow to preview immersive 3D and the final display color inside your Apple Vision Pro, MetaQuest 3 or 3S in near real time using the latest DaVinci Resolve 20. And to make it work seamlessly, I will also share a free Unity plugin you can download to stream your video straight into your headset using NDI. So if you are working with the Insta360 X5, the Canon EOS VR system, or any professional VR180 or 360 footage, and you want to edit confidently for MetaQuest, Vision Pro, or Android XR, this is the tutorial you have been waiting for. Let's dive in. Before you update to DaVinci Resolve 20, please backup your database. Click this little detail icon and hit backup. Resolve 20 will update your database, and if you didn't back it up, yeah, your ongoing project will be gone. Don't make that mistake. Now, good news, you don't need Resolve 20 to follow this tutorial. You don't even need the paid version, studio version. But just a heads up, the free version kept your output at 4K instead of 8K. Open up Resolve and create a new project with this exact setting. Under Color Management, you can choose DaVinci Resolve Color Managed if that's your thing. But for me, I like to manage color myself, especially when I'm mixing Insta360 X5 footage with the Canon R5C log and the red camera. So I go with the DaVinci YRGB, set timeline color space to DaVinci Y Gamut and DaVinci Intermediate. For output color space, I use Rec. 709 Gamma 2.4. Now, MetaQuest technically prefer Meta CV1, but I do want a master that plays nicely on both MetaQuest and the upcoming Android XR YouTube VR support. So Gamma 2.4 is a safe bet. It covers almost everything, except Apple Vision Pro. If you are targeting Apple Vision Pro, you will want P3 D65 Rec. 2100 ST2084 HDR. But today we are not covering that. That's in the next tutorial. This one, we are focusing on MetaQuest and YouTube VR, two platforms where you can actually make money. All right, let's drop in the ProRes render from the Canon EOS VR utility, head to the color page, and hit Option plus C a few times to create 5 nodes. I usually keep things minimum for immersive color grading. Why? Because the whole point of immersive capture is to show reality as real as it gets. Your world isn't orange and teal, unless you are colorblind or living in a Michael Bay movie. So, less is more. Here is the setup. First node is CST, Color Space Transform. Convert Canon C-Log 3 Cinema Gamut to DaVinci Resolve Y Gamut and Intermediate. Second to last node is your output CST. Go from DaVinci Y Gamut Intermediate to Rec. 709 Gamma 2.4. Boom, you will now convert your Canon log footage into final color space. It looks great on a 2D monitor, but we still have no idea what it looks like in VR. So now let's fix that and send this video signal straight to your MetaQuest. First, download and install the free NDI tool package. This gives you everything you need to receive and monitor NDI signals. Now, to send the video from DaVinci Resolve 20 to your MetaQuest wirelessly over the same Wi-Fi network, you will need a plugin or some kind of bridge software. There are a few ways to do that, but the one I found to be the easiest and most reliable, stable, is the Node Display NDI by Time in Pixel. It is affordable, runs super smooth, and works right inside DaVinci Resolve. Just to be clear, I have no affiliation with them or any software company, but I did reach out on your behalf and they are kind enough to give our community an exclusive 20% discount on Node Display NDI. It is not an affiliate link. I get zero kickback. So please don't go share this code with people who aren't subscribed. They haven't earned it yet. And if you appreciate Kimchi's endless effort to save you money in post-production, hit that like button and drop a thank you Kimchi in the comments. He read all of them. Once you have installed No Display NDI, go to the timeline level in Resolve, open your effect panel, search for No Display Connect or FS, and drop it onto your timeline. Now connect the input and output nodes in Node Graph. Make sure your system is using GPU for processing. Under image scaling, I recommend setting it to 50%, which gives you a 4K preview. I'm working on a latest Mac Studio with the M3 Ultra, so I can play back full 4K RAW in 60 frames per second. If you're on something a bit slow, 25% 2K is perfectly fine for grading. It will play back a lot smoother. Also, match your timeline FPS to your footage. Canon shooter is usually 59.94. Now, hit play on your timeline and open No Display. You should see your VR180 footage showing up in the No Display window. I'm screen recording this on an M4 Max MacBook Pro, and at 50%, I get about 40 frames per second. So if I drop it to 25%, I get a full real-time 60 frames per second playback. Next, open up NDI monitor, go to the NDI source list, and you will see your No Display 4K feed right here. Beautiful. Now, for the fun part, pick up that NDI feed wirelessly in your headset. First, let's learn how to do that in Apple Vision Pro. Yes, it's expensive, but the good news is this is the easiest setup. Download the free app Visio on your Vision Pro, open it up, and you should see that NDI feed right here. Pinch and hold that source to bring up the option menu, select Immersive 180 SPS, boom, you got yourself a real-time 60 frames per second immersive 2D playback inside Apple Vision Pro, wirelessly, no cable, just works. Now, for MetaQuest, I got you covered there too, thanks to the free APK Unity app developed by our good friend Kevin Ma. The download link is in the description down below, it's totally free. To install it, use the side quest to style the APK onto your quest. Once it's finished installed, put on your headset, go to a library, a node source, and open Project XTD. Tap Paththrough to see the real world around you. The latest paththrough on the quest is actually pretty good. Now select NDI input, and you should see your feed from DaVinci Resolve. Hit start. In the video bar, click the gear icon, select VR180 and choose side by side. Your Canon footage should now be playing back in real time directly inside your MetaQuest 3. Now, I know you can't see the 3D from my screen recording, but trust me, it is 3D spatial. The depth looks great. And yeah, it finally worked the way it should have. What about 360 video, like from the install 360 X5? The same workflow. Drop your X5 footage into the timeline, hit play, and put on your Quest 3. In the format dropdown, select 360 and mono. Boom! Full immersive 360 video. And yes, Kimchi is in the shot, right here. He is adorable. The NDI viewer support VR180, 360, 3D 360 top and bottom, and even spatial video side by side shot on your iPhone. And again, it's absolutely free with love. If this saved you time, money, and sanity, don't forget to like this video. And yeah, maybe thank Kimchi while you're at it. Now, back to color grading VR180 footage. Let's name the second node balance. This is where I do all my color grading in just one node. The next node is AI, where I will show you how to speed up your grading using AI tools. The last node is totally optional. I'm using Utility DCTL by Mononose. This little tool will help me nail skin tone, exposure, and saturation fast. First, jump in the DCTL and select Mono Balance. What you are looking for is the skin that show up yellow. That is the perfect balance. But here's the challenge. This scene is not easy. We've got Kitty who is white and a Kung Fu master with much darker Asian skin. This kind of mixed lighting, mixed tone scene is very tricky for immersive grading and white balance. So here's how I do it. Right click on the balance node, go to Gamma and switch to Linear. This is a VFX trick I picked up back in the day in Disney working in Nuke and After Effects. Color correction in Linear Gamma gives you the most accurate responsive curves. Then go to the Color Wheel section and then set the Luma Mix to 0. This turns your game wheel into a super accurate HDR control. Now, slowly push the game slightly toward green. That takes the purple out of the Kung Fu Master's face skin. Since he is main subject, we are going to balance based on his face and then find the sweet spot between his tone and Kitty's lighter tone. Don't overdo it. It is all about subtlety. With the linear gamma trick, here is the magic. You only need to touch one wheel and achieve a near perfect white balance, fast and accurate. If time saving trick like this help you out, go ahead and hit that like button and maybe subscribe. Kimchi will say thank you. Now turn off the skin tone overlay and switch to exposure heat map, also known as false color. Right away, you will notice Kitty's forehead is overexposed. Let's bring the gain wheel down to lower the overall exposure. In linear gamma, the gain wheel acts like a camera exposure control. You are adjusting luminance without shifting everything else, which is huge in immersive color grading. Write this tip down. Years of experience right here. Great color in the heat map is your target on skin around 60 IRE, which is where proper exposed skin tone should land. Once you are happy, turn off the utility CTL and check your before and after. Huge difference. Here is the thing. Because fisheye lens like this right here capture the full 180 field of view, you will almost always accidentally overexpose, especially if you are just eyeballing it on a 2D monitor. That's why utility DCTL is so important in my workflow. Now, if you are interested, I do have a discount code for our viewer. And if you're trying to save cash though, you can just use the basic skin tone indicator right here in DaVinci Resolve. But let's be honest, it's super slow and not practical for VR180, where the talent's face is tiny in the frame. And one last reminder, don't trust your 2D monitor. You've got to check everything in your VR headset to make sure it looks great. All right, let me show you one more of my secret tricks using AI to color grade. Look. I'm lazy, and AI is great for lazy colorists like me. Drop in the Color Lab AI node right here. This is a third-party plugin designed by my friend Dadu, a legendary Hollywood colorist who works on big-budget studio films. It's actually the only AI color grading software I trust. First, make sure you are working in the right color space, DaVinci Wide Gamut Intermediate for both input and output, then just hit balance. Boom! Look at that! Before, the sky was completely blown out. Now, we have recovered all the highlight detail without crushing the shadow on our talents. It's a beautiful natural balance. A great starting point if you want to add your own creative spin. Let's compare my manual color grade versus AI. AI gives you a more stylized look. My grading is more faithful to the original camera data. Which one you choose is up to you, but now you've got both options in your arsenal. Now let's talk about adding 3D graphic in immersive 180 video. Head back to the edit page and drop in the logo. Let's use Kimchi. The easiest way to insert graphic directly in 3D right inside edit page is with a plugin called Boards Effect Continuum VR Unit. Don't worry, I will also show you a free way to do this using Fusion later on. Drop in the BCC VR insert effects under preset, choose stereo left and right, open up the source setting and set the horizontal FOV to 180 degrees. Now we need to adjust insert convergency to place the Kimchi logo in front of Kung Fu Master and Kitty in actual 3D space.
But Hugh, how do you know where the 3D depth is?
You guess it, Kimchi. Put on your MetaQuest 3 or Apple Vision Pro, fire up the NDI viewer, and adjust the convergency while wearing your headset. Right about here, give me the most comfortable 3D, with Kimchi sitting nearly in the front, no stereo conflicts. Now, if you don't want to buy the Boards Effect plugin, here is the free way. We will use the Angel Hazelton's amazing Carterverse plugin inside Fusion. If you follow my other resort tutorial right here, you probably already have them. If not, what are you doing? They are free. Remove the Kimchi graphic from the edit page and let's head over to Fusion. Drop the Kimchi head graphic as media in 2, press Shift plus Spacebar to bring up the 2 search and add a KVR plane node. Connect the Kimchi graphic to that and plus 2 to send it to the viewers. Set projection to 180 VR and stereo input mode to mono. If you are using spatial video from an iPhone 16, then you will use horizontal or dual in. Set output mode to horizontal side by side and uncheck auto resolution and set it to 4096 by 4096. That is the pre-eye resolution for VR180. Next, add an auto domain node after the KVR plane. This keeps the aspect ratio clean. If things look weird after using any cutterverse node, auto domain usually fix it. Now add a merge node, make sure the kimchi logo is in the foreground and your VR180 footage is in the background. Send the merge node to the viewer. These are all standard Fusion VFX steps. If you are lost here, check out my other Fusion beginners tutorial right here. To composite the logo in 3D properly, add a temporary KVR viewer node right after the merge node, set image projection to 180 VR, disable tiny planet, and choose stereo, horizontal. Turn on anagraph, you will now see a red and cyan stereo separation. Keep your viewer window on a KVR view, but go back to KVR plane to adjust the convergency. If Kitty has cyan on the right, and Kimchi is supposed to be in front of her, move the logo slightly right until Kimchi's separation is stronger and bigger than hers. That tells you Kimchi is sitting correctly in front in 3D. When it looks good, delete the KVR viewer or just shift drag to disconnect it. Hit play and put your headset back on and use the NDI player to validate that it actually feels comfortable in stereo. And that's it! Now, I personally prefer the free method because I love Fusion. It is incredibly powerful once you learn to use it. But I guess it. If you're coming from an After Effects background, Fusion can be intimidating. So in that case, just grab the Boards Effect VR utility and stay in the edit page. Bonus tip. If you do get the Boards Effect, there's a lot more under the hood. With the 2025 update, they now have AI2 built in. You can automatically generate a 3D depth map from your footage. Great for 3D depth-based color grading. Or use the BCC Witness Protection ML to blur out faces in both eye of a 360 or VR180 clips. As you can see here, it track and blur every person in the space automatically, even in immersive footage, left and right eye. Huge time saver for travel video where you just cannot avoid tourists. This is just tip of the iceberg. If you want more tutorial on machine learning VFX for immersive video, drop a comment and I will share more on these tricks. And if you want to give Boards Effect a try, check the description. I've got a discount link below to help you save even more money. Now, what if you don't have a cute kimchi logo? Or what if you don't have a cute dog like kimchi at all? Well, don't worry, I've got you covered. Let me hook you up with some free graphic and text element for your next immersive masterpiece. Use the link below to download the free retro effects pack called Oldie but Goldie from Motion VFX. Completely free! Once you have installed it, just search for the pack and drop in one of the cool retro titles, turn on 4K quality, change the text to whatever you want, tweak the colors, and maybe add a drop shadow if you are feeling spicy. Then drop in the BCC VR insert again, or use the free cutterverse KVR plane I just showed you earlier in Fusion. Same deal, stereo left and right preset and 180 degree FOV. Look at that! Yep, now got yourself a stylish, old-school Bruce Lee-looking Hong Kong retro title ready for your next Kung Fu VR180 film. And you didn't pay a cent! And it gets even better. Motion VFX is giving away over 22,000 worth of prize just for using their free template in your project. If that campaign is ended, don't worry. I will keep the link updated with their next freebie. So if you are patient, you will be able to collect good-looking assets. You will build yourself a great little library of free visual elements to spice up your immersive video. Honestly, I don't know about you, but I love free templates. And that's one of the best parts of using DaVinci Resolve. So many pro tools and so many free resources out there on the internet. Okay, I've shared a ton of tips in this video, and everything you saw here is the exact workflow we use to create our 16K immersive film, Vanilla Lily, A Stroke of Destiny, a 22-minute spatial experience, fully funded by our amazing Patreon community. Remember, knowledge is power, and this is what I can offer to share what I have learned and help you succeed as an immersive creator. If you're new here, Kimchi and I would love for you to subscribe and join our growing immersive family. Check out Vanilla Lily here on screen to see everything you just learned in action. Thank you for watching, and as always, I will see you in Spatial.